you enjoy coming to Lynchville. This time, I've been here an hour, and I'm already ready to head back to the ranch.
There's not much happening, is there?
Well, there never is. Anybody know why they decided to call this place Lynchville?
Yeah.
Phil, I believe it was Abel said it was because they couldn't afford a sheriff, and they figured with that name, it'd keep all the undesirables away.
Yeah, along with everybody else. How's it going down and saddle the horses out by? I just remembered something I forgot.
Need some help?
No. You go ahead. I'll be with you.
Oh, I nearly forgot.
What?
Something I gotta do. You go on.
Oh, my wait.
No. It's all right. I'll catch up.
Hi, I'm back.
I think I got everything just about ready for you.
Papa's gonna love that chair. Telling me.
Oh, I thought you might be a little interested. Well, let me give you a hand with that, huh?
Oh, thanks. Her name's Wilhelmina Calhoun. I'll save you the trouble asking.
Thanks.
She and her pa's got a gold mine out in the desert south of here.
Well, whereabouts south, huh?
Well, nobody knows. Plenty of them tried to find out, though. Yeah, she comes into town about every 3 or 4 months to get supplies. Got this chair out of a catalog from Chicago. Been waiting here for her for 3 months. I'd sure be much obliged to you if you'd help me get this thing on the wagon.
Help me, miss?
Calhoun?
That was my grandmother's maiden name.
And if I'd said my name was McGillicuddy?
Well, then that would have been my grandmother's maiden name. Actually, I'm not too sure what her name was. Wagon's all loaded. I'd be happy to drive you home.
I can manage.
Yeah! She's quick. She likes me.
How can you tell?
She caught me in a lie. Nothing a woman likes more than a charming liar. Although, don't ask me why.
As a matter of fact, I really think she likes me.
Go on, you kid.
No, I'm serious.
I'll bet you a bottle of sarsaparilla and a bucket of snow to cool it that I get a date with her before you do.
That girl is sure pretty.
And rich, too.
I thought we were going to follow her.
Where are you? Gotta let her get a good start. We can't let her see us on her trail.
Sure be nice to have all that gold.
There you go. Counting your chickens before you even found a hen house.
Oh, we'll find it. I'll lead you right to it. I can track a bluebird across an empty sky.
How come the last place we was fired, the foreman said you couldn't find a stray to set in your lap?
We're gonna kill him, Jesse?
More likely.
That's where she left the road.
Yeah, there's a lot of dry country up ahead there.
Oh, yeah.
Hardly seems worth it just for a girl.
Nah. Let's forget it.
Let's forget, huh?
I think I'll ride on over to Juniper Springs and look for strays.
Yeah, good idea. I'll meet you back at the ranch, huh?
Yeah.
Take care.
Yeah.
Comes into town, I meet her at the old barn. She drives in, she gives me a dollar, then I drive out. Sometimes I come this way, and sometimes that way. I don't know where she goes.
Rest, thanks.
Virginia City. You wanted a Ponderosa Cartwrights, ain't you?
Yeah, that's right, Joe Cartwright.
What are you doing out here?
It's kind of hard to believe. I was looking for a girl, didn't find her.
I bet you're fit to be tied. Wow. Girl outsmarted us, but still got Cartwright.
A little mixed up, but I can still find that girl.
Couldn't find a stinkweed if it's in your mustache. Well, Cartwright's paw'll pay to get him back. Just ride to the Ponderosa, and old man Cartwright that gun belt and say, Bruce, we got your boy. Cost you $5,000. You want him back?
Well, what if he don't want him back?
The way I heard it, them Cartwright get along. They like each other.
Sounds more like friends than family.
Guess I got a what if for you.
What? What if old man Cartwright grabs the one rides in with that gun belt and says, all right, I got one of yours, you got one of mine, let's trade. Wouldn't do it.
Well, then you're gonna have to get somebody else to ride in with that gun belt.
Well, just leave it on the porch with a note telling him where to bring the money.
When he does, then we turn Joe Cartwright loose.
Maybe, Berg. Or just maybe.
Why don't we just take his horse and his gear over to Arizona and sell it? There's an easy $100.
All the way to Arizona.
Arizona.
For $100.
$100.
Yeah, well, $100 ain't a whole lot of money. You know that, don't
you? Well, $100 is a whole lot more money than we
got
now.
Yeah, but it's a long way from 5,000, ain't it?
Jesse.
Yeah, well,
Jesse.
What?
maybe we'd better sell the horse. Hmm? On account of Cartwright just escaped.
Why, you stumphead?
They're coming that far.
All right, Birch, that way. Horse.
He ain't got no gun. His hands are tired.
Are you two trying to wipe out the family?
I'm sure sorry, Jesse.
Come on. You look out there. He ain't out there. If he was out there, we could see him. Somewhere behind this damn rock. He's got to be. And we're going to find him, boys, if it takes all day and all night.
Jesse? Jesse, I've been thinking. Maybe we just ain't cut out for this line of work.
Thank you.
silly of me, but for a minute there, I didn't think you were going to stop.
Neither did I. Get in.
Thank you. Hey, what are you doing out here anyway? Figured you'd be home by now.
Why? I left after you did.
We followed you out of town.
That's the best way to keep people from finding you. Leave after they start following you.
Oh. Yeah! Not alive, we ain't.
Well, kind of saves us the trouble.
You know, for someone who keeps bragging about how good he is at tracking, I don't see how you could lose a full-sized man out here in this nothing.
It's a big desert. There's boulders out there and canyons.
Canyons.
Sure are.
You shut up and stay out of this. You ain't been no help neither.
Well, I told you I was sorry. Just I never had to keep anybody prisoner before.
Should have known better. Riding that watch, you lost half the herd, got us all fired.
Hey, look at how fast our tracks are filling up. It's no wonder Owen lost Cartwright's trail.
He's right, Jesse. Another 2-3 hours, they'll be gone.
Don't you tell me you ain't gonna be able to find the way back. You ain't telling me that, are you?
No, all we gotta do is just head right for those mountains, right over. Well, they kind of moved, or we did. But them's the ones we want, right there.
You better be right. Now, look here. We can still get that money. We'll ride into Virginia City and drop off this gun belt with a note. I'll give his horse a drink of water, turn him loose.
How come he gets the water and I don't?
Because he's a dumb animal.
He ain't so dumb. He's the one getting the water. This outlawing's harder work than working. And for less money. We ain't had a payday since we started.
There's a big reason for that. You two just can't remember to do what you're told.
Jesse, I've been thinking. Maybe if we rounded up them 2 bar T steers I lost, old Ed'd give us our jobs back.
The man told you he didn't want to see the likes of us in his part of the state again.
Now, that's what I'm talking about. What you're doing right now, that's what I'm talking about. You can't keep your minds on your work. Now, here we got $5,000 practically in our hands, and you talk about a 2-bit job. Now, we've been mare north most of the day. Virginia City ought to be straight west of here.
Right. And a little bit south.
Better hope you know what you're talking about. Bring him here for?
I couldn't leave him out there. He would have died.
Now that you bring him here, what are we going to do with him?
Papa, you're talking like he's some sort of a lizard that I brought home. You're wondering what we're going to feed him and which drawer I'm going to keep him in.
I wouldn't mind so much if he was a lizard.
My name's Joe Cartwright, sir. I'm not a lizard.
That remains to be seen.
Real friendly fella.
Are you a friend of his?
No, I just met him.
Then what do you expect?
Yeah, let me give you a hand with that. Easy. All right, where do you want?
Put it right over here. What'd you buy this for, Mina?
For you to sit in.
Already got a chair.
Yeah, but I'll get the rest of the thing.
It was pretty. I liked it, so I bought it.
We got too much stuff in here now. It's crowded.
Leave it here. We'll move something else out.
Out in the back, where we left that stuff, small mountain out there. Won't be no time for this thing to be full of mice.
You look like a girl.
Is that all?
Why, you look a lot like your mama.
Was she pretty?
She sure was. Almost as pretty as you.
I sure want to thank you for being so kind, taking me in like this, but I'm kind of late getting home. I should be on my way.
The sooner the better.
Yeah, well, I just want to borrow a horse and a couple of canteens for a few days.
You told me your name was Cartwright.
Right.
But you didn't say who was chasing you.
Well, there's nobody chasing me.
No? Well, a man roaming around in the desert out here without a gun or a horse, he sure wasn't out there to break in a new pair of boots.
No, you're absolutely right. See, I ran into these three fellas, and they robbed me.
Then you were chasing them when Mina found you.
No, not exactly.
Then they were chasing you. You got yourself caught out in a big fat lie, didn't you? I ain't about to loan my canteen or my horse to any lie.
Look, I can't get across the desert without a horse.
That's a fact. You sure can't.
Look, Mr. Calhoun,
you already admit consorting with outlaws.
I did not.
You know where my mind is. If you go riding around here, and the next thing I know, this whole place will be crawling with outlaws, bandits, and claim jumpers, and a lot of people trying to get something for nothing.
Well, I can't stay here.
You can leave whenever you want to, but my canteen and my horse stay here.
How long do you think I'm going to last on the desert without a horse?
How do I know? Maybe 3 or 4 hours. But I don't know. And chill.
Mina?
Just Mina. That's what Papa calls me. He used to say I was Mina the Miss and Mina the Mess. Why, I was the meanest thing alive. I'm not really. That's just his way of teasing me a long time ago.
Mina? Mina, I wonder if you'd do me one more favor. See, I want to get back to Virginia City.
Is there someone there that might be worrying about you?
Well, yeah, my pa, my brother. Do more than worry. They'll come looking for me.
I'll never find you here.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm afraid of. So I thought if I could just borrow a horse and a couple of canteens.
You'll have to talk to Papa about that.
Yes, I did talk to Papa, and I didn't do so good.
I'm sorry, Joe, but when Papa makes up his mind.
Yeah, but I can't stay here.
If you're thinking of stealing one of our horses, Papa's a fine shot with a rifle.
That doesn't surprise me.
He'd have good cause. It takes both horses to pull that wagon. Now, if you was to take one and something should happen to you, we'd never get out of here alive. But maybe you never thought about that.
Well, I'm beginning to think about it now.
Well, if you want to talk to Pop again, follow the path to the mine.
That way, huh? Thanks. I just wanted to talk to you one more time about the horse.
I want to talk to you one more time about the horse. You ain't gonna get my horse.
Now, look, I only need him for a little while.
Don't come screaming and hollering at me, boy. That way. That's the way to Virginia City. We don't owe you nothing. If it's anything, it's the other way around. Now, if you're gonna go, go. If you're gonna stay, mind your manners.
You know, I know I'm right, but for some reason you make me feel like I'm wrong. All right, I'll stay. I have no choice. But I'm going to warn you. I'm going to leave the first chance I get.
You can leave any time you want to. On foot. Now that you're here, I might as well show you around. Come on.
Ago, they said they were going to be right behind you.
Uh-huh. Maybe a horse threw a shoe or came up lame, broke a leg or something. Who knows?
They've got two horses.
Well, maybe one of them got hurt. The other one's staying there to look after him.
Fine. First we have an injured horse, now we've got an injured man.
Maybe both of them got injured.
Now we got two injured men. No, they're all right, I know that. They'll be back just as soon as they decide to come back.
Of course they will.
Where are you going?
Going out to the barn.
Going to saddle up a horse, Lopo?
Yeah,
I don't mind. I'll go with you.
Mr. Calhoun, you know that mine's dangerous. You need more shoring in there, heavier timbers.
I know it. I'll bring in a load of lumber every once in a while, but still ain't enough.
Well, look, I'd be happy to take the wagon into town and get you some more lumber.
Well, better go wash up for supper. It'd be getting dark pretty soon. Besides, need more like a slate sitting down. Well, we may camp here for the night.
We lost Jesse.
Call it that.
Well, Jesse, just what would you call it?
Undecided.
We need some water from the spring, Papa.
You should have told me that before I washed up.
Andy, see, the table looks great.
Thank you.
You look great, too.
Well, thank you. Won't you sit down? Papa will be back in a minute.
Right here. This is beautiful. Ed, don't you ever get lonely for somebody to talk to?
I've got someone to talk to.
I mean somebody your own age, women.
Well, what about?
I don't know. What do women talk about?
I don't know. Joe, what do women talk about?
Yes, you know, things. Homes, clothes, babies.
And what do they say?
I don't know. don't know, but they always have something to say.
What you got all them candles burning for, Mina?
Joe, what do you do? I mean, what do you work at?
Ranching, mostly. Thank you. And we do a little timber, some mining.
You only need one candle to show you what food is.
Where do you ranch?
A little spread outside Virginia City.
Just like eating supper in the middle of a brush fire.
Papa, with that company.
Well, it's a good thing we ain't got company every day, else I'd go broke buying candles.
Joe, where do you sell your cattle?
We drive most of them to the railhead.
All the way to Kansas City?
No, Carson City. The railroad will be all the way to Virginia City by next year.
You mean that I could go to Carson City, catch a train, and go all the way to Philadelphia?
Sure enough, you want to go to Philadelphia.
Nobody in his right mind wants to go to Philadelphia. Asked if I could.
Well, I said you could if you wanted to.
Joe, you'll have to excuse Papa.
This is my house, and nobody has to excuse me for anything.
Papa!
You just sit down and eat your supper.
I will not sit down and eat. I'm not a baby anymore.
Get too big for britches.
Something about the desert this time of day when things cool off.
That's when the bugs come out. You don't see a living thing all day long. Then the sun goes down and you're standing in a sea of bugs 8 feet deep. I hate it.
That is kind of rotten. How come you live out here?
I prefer bugs to people.
Oh, come on, now, what do you know about people?
I know enough. Papa's told me, and I've seen the people in town, the way they treat me. Talk about me behind my back.
Oh, now, come on. They're not talking about you behind your back. It's because you don't know them. You gotta make friends.
Well, why would they want to be friends with me?
Well, for lots of reasons. You're beautiful.
I am?
Sure you are. Hasn't anyone ever told you that?
Sure, Papa. But he's supposed to say that.
He's just telling you the truth. Look, if you lived in Virginia City, I'd be camping on your doorstep.
Would you?
Sure I would. We'd sit out on the porch or go for a buggy ride. Sundays, I'd pack a lunch, take you on a picnic.
And what would we do?
We'd sit and talk about how we felt, what we thought. I might try to hold your hand. Then I might kiss you. Then I might really kiss you.
In town, we can do that right here. I'll tell Papa.
Go tell him.
Then we're gonna get married.
But we what? Who said anything about getting married?
Well, isn't that what people do when they fall in love?
Usually they do, but this.
And you kissed me? Would you kiss a girl you weren't gonna marry?
No. Well, yes, I might, just to see what it was like.
Well, don't you know what it's like?
But yeah, I know what it's like, but you know, it's a little different with every girl.
And you've kissed someone you like better than me.
I didn't say that.
Well, just what were you saying?
Well, I'm saying I don't want to get married.
To me?
To anybody.
Then all you were doing was leading me on. Everything you said was a lie.
Oh, that's not so. I don't like the desert this time of night.
So at what point did you stop telling the truth and start lying?
Well, look, this must run in the family now. I know I'm in the right, and you make me feel like I'm in the wrong.
Joe, if it's gonna make you feel bad, you shouldn't tell lies.
Supper's getting cold, honey, so I put it in the oven.
Thanks, Papa.
Ain't you gonna eat? I'm sorry, I'd...
Papa, what's it like to be lonely?
Being alone, all by yourself, I reckon. Not like any company in.
Are you ever lonely?
What? Speck I am. Are you?
Papa, I want to get married. To Joe.
Well, you hardly know him, honey.
Well, that doesn't matter.
It does matter. It matters a whole lot. He might be a fugitive, a bank robber, a murderer, anything.
No, Papa. Why, he ain't even a good liar.
Well, that proves one thing. He ain't already married. I wish you'd take your time, Mina, and think about it. Because when you get married, it's for a long, long time.
I know that, Papa. Would you help me?
How?
Well, I don't think Joe wants to get married.
Well, that is something. But I think I got the answer.
Oh, hello, Joe. Come on in, Joe. Sit down. Have a drink?
No, thank you, sir.
How you like this place, Joe? How you like it here?
Oh, it's cozy.
How'd you like to stay around here?
Oh, you already know how I feel about that.
I know, but this is different. I'll show you. How'd you like to have a fall for that? The gold mine and everything.
You mean you're just going to give it to me?
Well, no, not exactly. Give it to you. Just a present. You know, a wedding present.
Who's getting married?
You and Mina. Now, wait a minute. I ain't going to take you in town to see the preacher. I'm going to go get him, fetch him back out here to perform the ceremony.
Yeah, I wouldn't be in too big a hurry to saddle your horse, Mr. Calhoun.
You can call me Luke Joe.
I don't want to get that friendly.
Ain't enough, huh? I had a third of everything.
But, Mr. Calhoun, it isn't
fair. Wait a minute now, Joe. Wait a minute, you're pushing me. I had half everything spread right down the middle. That's as far as I go.
I don't mean it isn't fair to me. It isn't fair to Mina.
Well, Mina ain't complaining, is she? Take it or leave it.
Look, Mr. Calhoun, you just
yes or no?
No.
Don't worry about Mina. It'll all work out. You being the only man here, and she being the only woman, in 6 months or a year, it'll all work out.
It's 6 months?
6 months? Ain't no time at all out here.
Marry you now if you were the only man in the world.
Look, Mina, out here, I am the only man in the world. And if you married me, it would be because you didn't have any other choice. And that's not right. Yeah, you have to meet other people. There's a whole lot of men that I'd like to marry you.
But you're not one of them?
Well, no, not out here, not like this.
What if we lived in town?
I told you I'd be camping on your doorstep.
Well, we wouldn't have to do that if you just...
Oh, Mina, I can't. Not like this.
Don't you ever want to get married?
Sure I do.
Then I'll wait.
Last time I seen him, it's heading right up this way. Said they had some personal business to take care of, and they'd catch up, but they didn't.
Sure wish I knew where they disappeared to.
You fellas looking for somebody?
Yeah, a young fella, Joe Cartwright. Another young fella with them, Candy.
Oh, yeah. Last I seen of them, they was helping Mina Calhoun load her wagon.
When was this?
Yesterday.
Do you know, did they ride out with her?
Not that I know of. They could have, though. I would have if I was their age.
Young gal?
Yep. And pretty, too.
Funny, I didn't see no gal.
Oh, I figured that horse. You'd have been with him if you had.
Hey, we gonna go looking for him?
No, I don't think so. I think, probably big enough to do their own courting by themselves.
Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Glad I could help.
Sure didn't see no gal.
Well, as long as you're here, you might as well make yourself useful.
Well, I didn't ask to stay here, you know.
No work, no food.
That's what I said, why I make myself useful.
She won't shoot anymore.
Well, you got here first.
Oh, gone.
I thought she lost you by that creek bed, back there by that blind trail.
Nah, she could lose me for a minute.
Oh, well, you won the bet. Hey, was it worth it?
Well, I'll tell you, I'm not sure. You know, she's kind of hard to get to know.
Oh, no. That's not... You're just not going about it the right way.
Well, you think you can do better, huh?
I'm the man that wrote the book.
Hey, well, look, I could use a few pointers. I'll even take care of your horse for you.
Well, that's very big of you, friend.
What's a friend for, huh?
Thank you.
Go to it. Have a good time.
Where's he going?
Don't matter, Pa. Let him go.
Howdy.
Papa?
Yeah, I guess he's fair trade.
Hmm? Well, I guess you figured we need a little time alone together. My name's Candy.
Candy what?
Just, Candy. You see, when I was a little boy, I was raised on an army post. And my daddy's name was Kennedy. Well, they naturally called me Kennedy.
Would you be camping on my doorstep?
Yeah, I would. And we could sit out on the porch and talk.
Or go on a buggy ride.
Yeah. And then on Sunday,
we could go on a picnic.
Down by the river.
Or we could talk.
Yeah. We could kind of get to know each other.
Hold hands.
And maybe I'd give you a little kiss.
And I'd kiss you back.
Hey, are you sure I don't know you?
get married.
Oh, well, maybe. In time.
Oh, we have time. Months and months and months. You sit down and finish your coffee. I'll be back in a minute.
Too much. If you do, he ain't gonna be able to tell us where the gold is. Hey, you down there at the cabin, I want to talk to you. What about? Got the girl. Cost you gold to get her back. All the gold you got.
Oh, that digging just to make that man rich.
They dig for more gold.
I know, but you don't realize how hard work it is, digging and blasting. My back just aches thinking about it. Hey, you up there! Here to pick up that gold. But put that girl out there where I can see she's all right. You hear?
All right, Bert. Get her out there in the open where they can see her. Come on. Virgil, he tries to run, kill her.
Why don't I just hang on to her instead? Jess?
Oh.
I got a what if for you.
I got a what if for you.
Hmm?
What if you just shut up?
Everybody be calm now.
Did he really mean that about killing me?
Well, it ain't what he means. It's what the fella down there thinks he means. That's the way outlawing works. Gotta keep folks scared.
Virgil, would you shut up?
Are you really an outlaw?
We're kind of working toward it.
Caught you, didn't we?
You wouldn't really kill me, would you?
No, ma'am. I sure wouldn't.
Is that all? Mind watching where he pulled that gun? Wouldn't want anything to happen to me now that I'm rich.
You just make sure the girl starts down when you start up, all right?
Oh, she will. She will.
Let everybody be calm.
Get the horses.
Come on, I'll get the rest.
Yeah.
Did you do that?
When I say tie him up, I don't mean tie him up. Get that on, Don. Come on. I got it. Oh, yes.
Ain't nothing ever going to come out right. You say what if I'm gonna kick you in the liver.
I'll take over the rest of the night. You get some sleep.
Yeah, sounds good to me, Mr. Calhoun.
Your friend's asleep out on the fresh hay near the corral.
It's good enough for a friend. It's good enough for me.
That was sweet what you said, Virgil, on the hill.
Wasn't nothing. If I wasn't going to jail, I would probably say a lot more.
Would you be camping on my doorstep?
I sure would.
Would we go on picnics?
I've never been on a picnic.
Well, we'd pack a lunch and go to the spring.
And what would we do?
We talk about things. How we felt. What we thought.
People talk about things like that?
Sure. And then we'd... I'd... Are those ropes too tight, Virgil?
Well, now you mention it, they are kind of cutting off the blood.
I'll do that.
Are you sure you still want it?
Sure as I've ever been, Papa.
I'd like to have a few words with you.
Sure. I wasn't planning on going anywhere.
Take him in and put him in jail.
Well, there's been some changes.
What kind of changes?
Well, I had a little talk with them last night. Found out they were innocent.
Innocent? You gotta be kidding. They're thieves. They tried to kill you.
Well, I did hear some shooting, but I can't swear to it.
Yeah, well, Mina can. She saw it all.
No, I'm afraid not, because a wife can't testify against her husband.
Her husband?
Yeah, Butch. That's the reason why Jesse was riding to town to fetch back the preacher. Sure gonna be nice to have three strapping in-laws help me with my mind. Butch is gonna make a fine husband for Nita. It wasn't my first choice, I gotta admit that. You two boys are fine, upstanding citizens. Now, if you could see some way we could change your mind, one of you.